So two of the most unique settings in Camera Raw have now found their way into Photoshop. That is dehaze and clarity. Right now we're going to have a look at it. I'm going to touch on what the difference is. I'm going to show you where to use each one, and then I'm also going to show you how to combine them in the end. And this feature is just in Photoshop beta for now, and I have other tutorials that show you how to get that if you don't know. I'll also link underneath. So in order to understand difference between clarity and dehaze, we have to understand frequency. So most images can be broken up into high frequency, mid frequency, and low frequency. The best I heard it described was from Max Wendt at Adobe. He said that the high frequency is the details, mid frequency is the features, and low frequency are the areas. So for example, high frequency is fine details, such as the grain in the ground, the textures. We look at these leaves here. Mid frequency is kind of like the forms of these bamboo. Low frequency is this area here with the waterfall where there's no distinct detail, but is kind of light and darker areas. Now be aware that these are not in regions in the image. Every part of the image has the different frequencies. For example, the woman, you can consider a lot of her in a mid frequency, but low frequency would be the skin on her legs. High frequency could be her hair or some of the folds in her clothing. All right, so let's start with an image and we're gonna use clarity. So we're gonna go under the layers and we're gonna grab an adjustment layer and we're gonna choose the setting clarity and dehaze. So this feature has always been available inside of Camera Raw and Lightroom, and now for the first time, it's available in Photoshop. Now we have some advantages having it in Photoshop is that we can use it on layers. We can also use it on layered documents, make it very easy to use Photoshop's powerful selection and mask tools to apply it exactly where we want. So what clarity does is it increases contrast, but mainly in the midtones. To demonstrate, I've got this chart. Keep an eye on this bar at the top. On the left, we've got highlights. On the right, we've got blacks and shadows. In the middle, we've got the midtones. Watch how this moves mostly in the midtones. See that? Also pay attention to this area here where we've got lights and we've got darks and then we've got midtones. As I increase the clarity, notice how it really affects those midtones more than anything. And then you can see the result on some of these images here. So there's zero. As we increase it, see how it makes the images appear sharper by increasing that midtone contrast. This works similar to Unsharp Mask. Let me show you. So if we go Filter Sharpen and we go to Unsharp Mask, as we increase the radius, what it does is it actually puts a halo around the edges. It brightens up the light areas, darkens the dark areas, and creates this edge halo, which gives the appearance of having more sharpness or more definition. And this is similar to how clarity works. It's not exactly the same, but as you can see, there's definitely some similarities. Now, Unsharp Mask works on a high frequency, whereas this works on the mid frequency. So we can increase clarity to bring out the detail here. So if we look at our outfit, see how it really makes the detail pop. You might not want to apply it to the face. It's not flattering in skin tones, however. So the nice thing about using it in Photoshop is we can select the mask, grab a brush, set it to black, and then with that black brush, as we paint, we can paint it away from the areas we don't want it. So we could also choose the person mask here. And we could grab the different parts of the skin. Notice we could grab the arms, the upper body, skin, hands. And then when we apply that, we could use that mask here to help us brush it out of the areas we don't want it. Just from her skin, namely. So when we look at it before and afterwards, now it's just affecting the areas we want. So this is just one way we can use it. Clarity also works really well on landscape photos. Say for example, this old barn, I want to really bring out some of the texture and the grunginess of this scene. If we use clarity in dehaze, increase that clarity, and look at that. We can just really make that pop immediately. So dehaze mainly affects the low frequency areas, which, as I said earlier on, are more areas, not so much objects or detail. It also boosts the color. And this gives it the ability to do exactly what it was created for, and that's to cut through glare and haze on your images. But it also works really well with skies. So let's have a look at dehaze. If we look at this particular image here, notice there's a little bit of haze in the background with these boats. If we increase it, notice the definition increases. If we go the other way, we can add haze or add atmosphere to the image. So sometimes this is a nice effect as well. Another area where dehaze really shines is with skies. So if we add it here, but notice how much detail here we can bring out in these clouds very, very easily. And of course, once again, because we're working with an adjustment layer, we can easily mask it into the areas we want to. I could just grab the brush. I could use a sky mask, or I could just grab a big black soft brush and just paint it away from the areas I don't want it. And you can see how quickly and easily we can boost just our skies. And it can also really shine in images like this. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to start combining the two adjustments so you can see how to use them together. So if we go to clarity and dehaze, watch what happens in this kind of hazy area here as we push the dehaze. Notice we can cut through all that glare. But notice it doesn't do much as far as bringing out the detail in the mid frequencies. See that? Doesn't affect that too much. But if we bring the dehaze up a bit, and then we combine it with clarity, now watch what happens in these areas here. Notice how that just really pops the other areas. Now be careful not to go too far, because with the clarity, it's very easy to get an artificial look. In fact, when the faux HDR grunge thing was a big thing, clarity was used a lot for that. We're really starting to bring out the image here, and if we look at this before and after. So what we're doing is we're adjusting our low and mid frequency, but we're not touching the high frequency yet. And this is where we combine it with things like Unsharp Mask. So if we go to the background, let's right click and convert it to a smart object. That way the adjustment's going to be non-destructive. Then we're going to choose Filter, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask. And notice as we give it a little bit of a push here, we can see now we're affecting those areas here. Before and after. It might be a little subtle on your screen. But if we look at what we've done to the image, it's quite subtle, but look at how much more definition it gives the image. Clarity and dehaze with Unsharp Mask. Now we're bringing so much more definition to the image than we had before. I've already done a more detailed tutorial on the difference between dehaze and clarity. I'll link to that, but let me show you the hero image. It's where you can really see the difference. So if I go in and I choose clarity and dehaze, watch what happens. Clarity, remember I told you the mid frequency? See how it affects it. Really cuts between the bamboo here in the background. But notice it doesn't affect the low frequency around here very much. But it's really affecting that mid. And then if we go into the dehaze, notice, see how it really affects that low frequency. It touches on the mid frequency, it just kind of darkens it, adds a little bit more color to it, but that's about it. So we can combine these two together to really make an image pop. Now the last thing to be aware of is when you use the dehaze, quite often it boosts the saturation. So what you might want to do is just tweak that back when you're finished. So we're just going to grab the adjustment layer, and what we're going to do is choose the color and vibrance. So we're going to grab the vibrance and saturation and just maybe pull the vibrance back just a little bit. There we go. And by doing that, we can bring it back to the more natural colors. But if you want to know the difference between clarity and dehaze in a much more detailed tutorial, check out this one here that I've already done. And drop a comment underneath and let me know, what do you think about these features? Personally, I think they're really useful in Photoshop. I'd like to know what you think. And also, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.